What's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. This is Cora. Today I will show you how to manually request your PIN using PIN Troubleshooter and how to set up wire transfer as your primary mode of payment in Google AdSense. It is a very common issue here in the Philippines about the delay in receiving the PIN through mail, or some of the YouTubers did not receive the PIN through mail at all. Some of us went to the post office and found out that the PIN was just there. Some of us went to the post office and the PIN was not there. For whatever reason, we don't know. Google AdSense allows us to request three times before we can use the PIN Troubleshooter. Each request, you will need to allow 3 to 4 weeks. If still not received, you can request again. After all the requests, it could take up to more or less 4 months before you can use the PIN Troubleshooter. So it's kind of frustrating. So let's say you are done with the 3 requests and you still don't have the PIN. I will show you how to use the PIN Troubleshooter to manually request your PIN. I will switch to my desktop mode.
Okay, so first, we have to log in first to our Google AdSense. Desktop ang gamit ko ngayon, so para mas madali natin siyang makita. So, just add another tab. Nakaset na kasi, or nakabookmark na kasi itong AdSense namin. So, I'll just click on it. So, wait lang natin. So, nandito siya. Wala na yung to-do list ko kung saan maglalagay ng PIN. Kasi na-verify ko na kasi yung akin. So, what we will do, since ipapakita ko sa inyo kung paano gamitin ang PIN Troubleshooter, dito tayo sa help. Ayan. Yung question mark sa tabi ng bell. Tapos, click mo yung problem with your PIN. Kasi dito natin makikita ang PIN Troubleshooter. And then you will see here, meron din ditong mga reasons kung bakit hindi nare-receive yung PIN. Ayan. At kung alin ano-ano ang mga i-check, what you will check, why you are not receiving the PIN. But for me, all are good, so that's why I used PIN Troubleshooter. So at the bottom portion, ayan, you will see the PIN Troubleshooter button. Just click on it. There you go. And then you will be asked like 3 questions. So there. First question is, are your earnings greater than the verification threshold? So I click yes because I have reached it. And then, have you received your PIN? So no. All right. Have you already requested 3 replacement PINs? So yes. And then after that, makikita mo itong you'll have 4 months from the date of your first PIN and blah blah blah. So, but the most important thing here is the contact us. We will click on this kasi na request mo na ng 3 times and then wala pa rin yung PIN. So, for example, this one, you will input the information, your legal name, of course. Let's say, for example, I'll use. Kasi ito yung nakapangalan sa aming Google AdSense. And then your email address, of course. And then your AdSense publisher ID. So, paano mo siya nakikita? Meron ding ways para makuha mo ang yung Google, I mean, AdSense publisher ID. So, pwede mo siya i-check dito. Payments. And then, nakuha natin siya. And dito yung iyong publisher ID. Pwede rin siyang makita dito sa settings, ayan, publisher ID. Another thing na makikita mo ang iyong publisher ID ay sa iyong studio. Ayan, monetization, and then dito tayo sa ating publisher. Parehas lang naman yan, so we will use this one, okay, copy, paste. Publisher ID, kailangan lagi siyang nagsistart sa PUB dash and then the numbers. And then this time, kailangan mong mag-upload ng valid IDs. Let's say, for example, kung meron ka ng passport And then meron din dapat address, okay? If you have postal ID, SSS ID, government IDs na merong pangalan, ayan. Please make sure to attach clear and visible proof of identity in order to confirm the validity of postal address set in your AdSense account. Pwede yung government-issued ID, pwede yung bank statement, telephone bill, or rent receipt. Basta mayroong pangalan mo, full name, and the address. So you'll just have to upload, let's say, for example, anything here. You have to make sure na ang i-upload mo is yung valid ID. Let's say, for example, you have uploaded, So, open, it's uploaded, and then click on submit. Alright, submit manager. This time, I will not click on submit because I have already done this one. Now, once you have submitted that, there will be an email. You will check your email. You will log into your email. Bookmark here. Meron kayong marireceive na email from Google AdSense. Ayan. So, naka-receive kaagad ako ng email from Google AdSense Support. Ayan. So, papakita ko sa inyo yung kanilang mga emails nung after ko sinend yung valid documentations to verify my address. So, ayan. Nakikita niyo. From, pakita ko sa inyo guys. Ayan, okay, this is, kita ko sa inyo, from AdSense support at google.com, 12:46 PM, 7 minutes ago. Ayan, tsaka ako nag-decide na i-record itong aking email. Ayan, yung content ng kanyang email. And then, less than a minute, nakareceive agad ako ng another email which has been approved from, of course, from AdSense support. Ayan, 12:46 PM, 7 minutes ago. Less than a minute yan, guys, after nung unang email nila, nakareceive agad ako. So, ito yung sabi niya na, thank you for sending your proof of identity. And then, ito yung list ng next steps. So, tatlo yun. So, una, dito tayo sa set up your form of payment for AdSense. Dinadirect tayo diretso doon sa kanyang step 1 na sign in. Okay, pinlik lang yun. Tapos, dito sa ating setup, how to set up your form of payment, meron tayo itong 7 steps. Susundan lang din natin yan. So, first one, sign in. So, pag i-click natin yan, i-direct tayo doon sa ating homepage ng ating Google AdSense. So, nakikita natin, nasa homepage na tayo, and then check natin yung step number 2, click payments, and then sunod-sunod na po yan, click payments, and then, yan, of course, manage payment methods, and then add payment method, yan, sunod-sunod na po yan, makikita na nandito sa ating Google AdSense, yan, add payment method, yan, dito tayo, okay, so, ayan, makikita naman po ninyo, ayan, sinundan ko lang ang lahat ng steps just to make sure. So, sa ating add payment method, nandito na tayo. Merong dalawang options dito sa ating add payment method. So, meron na kang makikita ang add new wire transfer details and add new check details. Ayan, pag i-click nyo po yung add new check details, yan po ang makikita yung information na kailangan para sa check add new check details na mode of payment. Yun yung pag gusto nyo ng check yung nare-receive nyo na payment from Google AdSense. Yun po yung kanyang mga details na kailangan. But for us, kasi parang hassle in our part pag check siya at saka parang matagal siyang ma-receive kasi meron pa siyang mga gagawing verification. So, we opt to choose the wire transfer mode of payment. Pinapakita ko lang sa inyo yung kailangan, details na kailangan kung check payment ang inyong mode of payment from Google AdSense. So, balik tayo sa add new wire transfer details sa ating payment method. So, ito yung mga informations na kailangan kapag wire transfer. So, mas preferred kasi namin ito para automatic siya, not instant, but automatic siya, bank-to-bank kasi itong process na ito. Yan, kailangan nakaset as primary payment method natin na nakacheck siya. So, sabi ni AdSense, it will take within 5 days na mag-reflect yung payment nila sa banko mo. But in our experience, wala pang 12 hours nag-reflect na agad yung payment nila sa banko namin. So, ito yung kailangan natin, name of bank account, tapos bank name, tapos Swift BIC, ayan, sinerch pa namin yan kung ano ang Swift BIC ng depende kasi iba-iba ang Swift BIC ng per bank. If you are using BDO, Metro Bank, Security Bank, or any other bank, hindi kailangan na may dollar account ka. Any account, bank account will do, kahit yung Kabayan Savings, pwede rin po yun. Yung yellow sa BDO, yan, pwede rin po yun. For as long as mabigay mo yung kailangan ni Google dito na information. I-input lang namin ang aming name of the bank, a name on bank account. For example, you have to make sure that whatever name is written on your bank account, that should be the name written on your Google AdSense. And then here is the bank name. Just copied it. BDO Unibank Incorporated. Yeah. We have verified and checked it a couple of times again and again. We just want to make sure that we are putting in the right bank, the right name of the bank. Okay, copy and paste it. And then the SWIFT code of the bank for the Euro, BDO Unibank Incorporated. It is 8 characters, the SWIFT code. And then of course, this time is the account number. You have to double check or triple check your account number so that you will not mistype it. We want to make sure that we are typing in the correct account number and then the bank account details. And then leave other details blank, it's okay. So you have to double check everything, double or triple check. You have to make sure that we are in trying to put in the correct details. And then of course, yes, it is set as primary. So it should always show as primary, okay, wire transfer to bank account, and then there is the last three of the account number with the bank account name. Okay, so there you go. How you get paid, it is already in your Google AdSense. The primary mode of payment, that is wire transfer to bank account. And that's it. It is already successful.
So that's it for today, guys. I hope you learned something out from this video. And if you like this one, please give me a thumbs up. And if you're not a subscriber yet, please make sure to subscribe and hit the bell for all notifications. Do not forget our Facebook page, that is Unboxing and Everything, and our Twitter account, that is Unboxing E. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll see you again on my next video. Bye! Love ya!